why this is significant is because reservists live in areas throughout the country, as well as undertaking at different times naval service. So in effect, they are the ambassadors of the naval idea throughout the country. And this book is all about that particular contribution. Significantly, it goes beyond the 100 years, 1910 to 2010, although that's part of the title. We found in looking at the theme that it takes us right back to the beginnings of New France. So that these are the traditions out of which the Naval Reserve has grown.
The Naval Reserves tend not to get a lot of specific attention in our history, and yet, as this book demonstrates, they've been critical at a number of key moments over the century.
And if we look at the service that has been rendered by the reservists, if we look, in fact, at the histories of the two components, we'll see there have been occasions where there would not have been a Navy had it not been for the Naval Reserve component. There would not have been a naval force in World War II if there hadn't been citizen sailors who came from their civilian professions to be temporarily in the fleet.
Much like the Naval Reserve, this project was started with a simple idea from currently serving members who wanted to capture the history of the Naval Reserve, not only for those of us who serve in the Naval Reserve, but for our nation. What makes this project different than any other is that this book was conceived and written by members of the Reserve, predominantly Naval Reservists, and we're very, very proud that the history was captured this way.
It'd be valuable to Canadians, it'll be valuable to the regular force Navy, and I think it'll be especially valuable to the Naval Reserve to help them better understand their place in Canadian society.